Most unwanted. Oh, I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry. There's a case? Or like a real case? Like a real X-Files? Like this is an X-File? Are you sure? Because I mean, there hasn't been much going around down here. Yeah, there's a few holes in the ceiling. So you need to fly to California. San Diego. Okay. I'll check it out. I'll see what's going on. Hoaxes happening at Comic-Con. What's Comic-Con, ma'am? Oh, it's that nerd convention. Okay, alright. I'll figure it out, ma'am. I'll figure it out. I'll see what's happening. Alright, thank you. Yes! San Diego won't know what hit them. There's been some eyewitness accounts of UFO activity. I have author Sam Sykes here with me right now. Sam.
Yeah.
You just told me that you saw some aliens walking around Comic-Con. What did they look like?
I did. They looked...
Tell me. Come on, son. Tell me.
Like me.
Okay. Let's go. Let's go.
Okay.
Let's go. I have Waldo here. Have you ever found an extraterrestrial?
Unfortunately, no.
Do you find anything?
I mean, I get found.
I have here Victoria Schwab. Here in San Diego,
yeah.
Comic-Con, would you say that there are aliens walking around with us right now?
I would say there are some very strange people walking around with us. Whether they're aliens or not, I just can't say.
Have you seen them ever flying around in like an unidentified object?
No, I have not. Have you?
No, I haven't, so that gives me hope.
I am not.
Okay, good.
I can assure you.
I think we have some UFOs up here. I have author Renee IDA. Do you believe in extraterrestrials?
Absolutely.
Have you ever seen one?
Not yet.
I'm here with author Saba Tahir. Have you ever written about extraterrestrials?
I plead the fifth.
So you have?
I plead the fifth.
Do you think they're here at Comic-Con?
If they were gonna be any place, it would be Comic-Con.
Okay, so I have a lead witness here for the UFO sightings, Miss Christine Riccio. What have you seen here at Comic-Con?
I've seen multiple extraterrestrials walking around in my presence.
Okay.
And it's been very uncomfortable.
Can you describe those extraterrestrials?
Yes, they look almost human. But you know they're extraterrestrials because they're not dressed up at all.
Okay.
And that's what's the scariest, because you don't know if they're real humans or if they're fake humans.
Okay.
What is that? What is that? That.
So I'm here with author Scott Sigler. Have you ever seen any unidentified flying objects here in San Diego?
Yes, there's been quite a few of them. Most of them happen to be shaped like wheelbarrows, usually stuffed with many kittens, calicos, striped cats, few street cats. Some of them are a little bit emaciated and they have green eyes.
Oh, wow.
You might not know they're aliens except for the antenna sticking out of their little kitty heads.
You think they're aliens?
Oh, they're clearly aliens because they keep saying, I want to eat human souls. So, I mean, I'm assuming they're not real cats.
That's worrisome.
Have you ever heard of the X-Files?
No.
Have you ever heard of Mulder and Scully?
Maybe. I've heard of them.
Okay.
I don't know them.
I've had some reports that there are people impersonating Mulder and Scully. They used to be on the X-Files. Now that's my job as Agent Gina Harper.
Oh, so they're aliens too?
Danielle.
Yes.
Where do you think aliens hail from?
Outer space.
Oh. If you see any more things, just keep in contact
with
me.
Are you like Men in Black?
Yes.
This looks suspicious. Very suspicious.
Should I be worried for the people here at Comic-Con?
I think the death toll will probably be in the thousands, if not potentially up in the millions.
Okay, all right. We're evacuating the area. Evacuating the area! Have you ever heard of the authors Kemi Garcia and Jonathan Maberry?
Yes, I have.
Have you heard the reports that they're writing a new X-Files story?
I've heard the rumors. It's pretty scary.
Yeah, the X-Files are real.
Yeah.
That's what I investigate. Do you think it's appropriate for them to be writing about real life stories?
I mean, are they in danger? Should I be warning them? I'm a little nervous here.
You mean about me?
Yeah. Are you gonna hurt my friends?
No, I'm not.
She looks like she might hurt my friends.
I'm not gonna hurt them.
Here we have YouTuber Sasha Alberg, also author of Zenith. She writes about sci-fi things, so I figured she might have some insight. Sasha, how do you feel about crop circles?
I love crop circles. I go and study them, and they show up all over the cornfields of Illinois where I live, so there's always an abundance of them.
So you've seen one in real life?
Yes.
We have an eyewitness here. Eyewitness right here.
Have you seen them here at Comic-Con?
You saw one. Guy.
The cat guy?
The cat guy.
Can you elaborate?
He had a dead cat with its brains hanging out.
Oh my gosh.
And he was in bloody smocks.
Are you kidding?
And the cat was moving in his arms.
I think we have a lead here. We have the X-Files authors. They are creating the origin stories of Mulder and Scully. They exist. Why are they creating the origin stories? Because they're right there behind me. This is not a drill. This is not a drill. FBI? You're FBI?
Yes.
Yes. Well, you're not FBI.
This way I am.
I don't believe it.
I know how to get out of a trunk of a car.
You want to believe, don't you?
I know how to get out of the trunk of a car from the inside with no release.
I know how to collect evidence of a crime scene.
Okay, maybe I do believe.
I am here with the authors of the new X-Files origin stories, Kemi Garcia and Jonathan Maberry. And I also have their editor, Erin, with us today as well. We're going to be talking about their new X-Files books and how they are delving deep into Mulder and Scully's stories. I'm very excited about this. I am a huge X-Files fan. You guys should know this. It's my favorite television show of all times. My parents watched the show and then I watched the show later. How did you guys become fans of the X-Files?
A friend of mine had seen the first episode and said, dude, there's a great show, you've got to watch it. He brought a videotape, back when there was videotape, over of the first episode. So we watched the second, watched the first, and then we rewatched both. We were hooked. And
so this was like when it first aired?
When it first aired, and I've been a fan ever since. Read all the novels,
Wow. Seen
the shows a million times.
What's your favorite episode?
Favorite episode is actually Darkness Falls from the first season.
Mine's Paper Hearts.
Yeah.
That's a good one too. Which one?
Sizzgizzy. No one can pronounce the name of the episode.
That's why it's your favorite.
It's my favorite.
I love the episode Home.
Home is great.
Oh, you
so
like the creepy
scary
one.
Yeah, I love that episode.
And I watched it when it first aired too. I am a believer. Like,
you're
I'm superstitious.
Okay.
Like, I'll watch anything supernatural, paranormal, alien. That's my kind of show.
Yep. Okay. Since 1993, we've all been fans.
Wow. So we have the original fans here, and they are writing the stories, so I think you guys are well equipped to write Mulder and Scully's story.
I think nobody is better equipped to write the stuff than we are.
How did the idea of the like young adult Mulder and Scully stories come about?
Well, Jonathan had this idea a long time ago.
Okay.
I've been editing the X-Files anthologies for IDW.
Oh, wow.
Chris Carter did approve the stories as official canon. So we actually set the stories between existing episodes. So they are official stories.
Okay, so I was going to ask you, are they canon?
Are these stories
canon?
When I was doing the second volume, I had approached them to say, I would like to do an anthology of young Fox Mulder. And at the time, they didn't think there was enough interest because the show hadn't yet been greenlit for the 11th season.
Okay.
So just to prove that it would be a great idea, I asked Cammy to write a story for the second volume. And she wrote a young Fox Mulder story, Black Hole Sun. It was brilliant. Everyone liked it. Everyone talks about it. That plus when the series came back, it really kind of helped goose things along. And she and I started having conversations that these should be books, not just anthologies. They should be novels.
Once the person from Fox and, you know, Chris Carter's team and everyone had given him such a great response, but he's like, you know, what are we going to do? And I said, I know someone who's an editor and publisher who loves the X-Files.
Yep. Erin!
Erin is my editor at Little Brown and mm-hmm. has edited a lot of my stuff. And now she is a publisher at Imprint. Mm-hmm. She's her own Imprint. And I said, there's a possibility of doing X-Files stories, original novels. And she said, ask Jonathan who I need to speak to, and then you two do nothing. And she said, because no one
can
make
these
books.
I'm going to go make it happen. So how closely have you been working with Chris Carter, who is the creator of the show?
Well, he's everything has to be
approved. We don't get to hang out with him. We don't get to have coffee with him, but he and his team look at everything. Okay. These books will be canon, and they're totally official.
Okay, are they pumped? Is Fox pumped about this?
So,
okay,
Fox
good.
Stopped by yesterday.
Oh, yeah, that's so cool.
They're so excited.
Is there any way that these would ever be adapted into television?
Well, that conversation has started. But
it has
not
started.
Not up to us. It's not up to us.
Yeah. It would be awesome.
Would it be fun for you guys?
Yes.
Yeah.
And also, I think it would be a really great thing for teens because there's a whole new generation of stories you can tell. Mm-hmm. You know, both retro from the 70s, but with a 21st century vibe that, you know, I think it's the perfect time for it. And you can get a couple of hot young actors to play them who would, you know, career building you know, for them. And plus it would have that nice little tie into the older series so the kids could read that or watch that and then
go back and binge
old and new X-Files for
adults. Yeah, that would be awesome.
There's nothing but win in this.
Stories for us is always, you know, it's really about, like, how did Scully become a skeptic and how did Mulder become a believer?
Okay.
But embedded within what we're writing, you know, it's very much, you know, coming of age. Like, Scully's dealing with a sibling. Mulder's dealing with, like, the problems with his father and the tension of losing his sister.
That's a family drama.
All this kind of your demons, you know. Mm-hmm. All the things that you really do grapple with as a teen. Mm-hmm. So it's not, I mean, they're really deep novels in a sense that the characters are really, you know, going through a lot, not just like having a cool X-Files plotline.
Yeah.
Well, you know, in the original TV show, there's a lot of elements about trust and can you trust, who can you trust,
exactly.
And so on. And I remember from my own teen years that trust was a big issue all the time in everything.
Yes.
You know, can you trust what your parents have told you? Can you trust who your parents are? Can you trust your friends?
Yeah.
Can you trust your own integrity? You know, as a teenage boy, you know, I had to decide what kind of guy I wanted to be. Do you want to establish trust and what does that mean? Trust is a big thing in all of this.
Okay.
So it's not just belief, it's also trust.
Yeah.
And that is a great through line and element in our novels as well.
And I'm so interested to see, like, how you guys have worked the characters in becoming like who they are in a television show.
It's a lot easier than I thought it would be.
You're doing an
amazing
job. So much fun.
I feel Chris Carter, because they are so well formed as adults, and because we both are so comfortable writing YA, mm-hmm. it's easy for us, you know, to kind of work backward and think, like, if you turn out this way, how did you start? That's why I love origin stories, and I've always wanted to. I read comic origin stories. I've always wanted to write one because I love to think about, like, how did this person, what made them evolve into this?
Yeah. Got it.
You know, what was the beginning and the kernel of whatever it is, the doubt,
the forces at work. So much going on in any one person's life.
And the show gave little hints here and there, which I've been rewatching and combing for all those little hints, but they didn't really talk that much about their teen years at all.
They didn't.
We don't really know any details, especially Scully. We know nothing about her teenage years, so it's so fun to fill in those blanks.
Yeah.
It is.
Did you guys have to play rock, paper, scissors to figure out, like, who was going to write the Scully story and who was going to write the Mulder story, or did you just...
I have four brothers. Uh-huh. Jonathan has sisters.
Four sisters.
I know nothing about...
Oh, my gosh.
Until I had a daughter, I know nothing about girls.
I asked Cammy to write Mulder, and I asked Jonathan to write Scully, because I thought...
You figured...
That was actually a better personality matchup.
But you've written girls before, and I've written POV for boys.
And you did put your stamp on young Fox Mulder in that short story, so it works. It's going to work out really well.
Okay. Are there any X-Files characters from the show showing up in the book?
Yes.
Okay, who?
We can't tell you all of them, but in the sampler, you will see the cigarette smoking man and Mr. X.
Oh.
And so there are others, but if I told you, I'd have to kill you.
He's in Agent of Chaos in the Mulder story. He's not in the Scully story. Other members of the syndicate show up in the Scully story. Also, we get a little more backstory about her dad, Bill Mulder, and his involvement with the syndicate. We're coming into the existing, and respecting the existing mythology.
Totally.
We're coming into it in ways that kind of open it up and show that it was much more complex and was much more at work in the world even before Mulder and Scully.
There was a reason they both ended up at the FBI.
Yes.
Okay.
And what are those reasons?
That makes me excited. Mulder's coming out of high school.
Mulder is at spring break, so it's his senior year. He will be graduating, and he'll be turning 18 in the fall. So he's like, you know, 17 and change.
And by the way, the stories take place at the same time.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
How long is the story? Is it like, does it take place within a week?
Mine's days.
Yours is days.
Days.
Okay.
Very quick. Maybe a week.
They're really intense.
Fast paced. A lot is happening. What's cool is they're set in 1979, because that's so when they were these ages. But in 1979, the two most popular things were Star Trek and Star Wars. So it's not that different from 2016, actually.
No, it's not. Not at all. Are you picturing the actors as you're writing?
I found like David Duchovny,
like super young
pictures.
Okay.
And because to, you know, to everyone, and even in the comics, you know, that is the character that we all envision. Mm-hmm. So I literally found like 16, 17 year old pictures of him. Where his hair is a little feathered and long.
Oh my gosh. Is his hair feathered?
A little, it's kind of like long. A little
it's
shag.
Amazing.
But he's very hot.
Oh, okay.
And I think Gillian Anderson tweeted a photo of him looking like that a couple days ago.
Oh.
I'm using that because I, you know, obviously I want him to age up to look the way we all know he looks.
I found pictures of Gillian Anderson around 20, but nothing when she's a teenager yet. But I have found pictures of the actor who played her father, the actress who played her sister.
Really?
Found them as younger, so it gives me a sense of what they look like. Jillian was very soft, and she became a little more sharp-featured.
Yeah, she did. She did.
Which nicely fits the trajectory of her story.
Is there anything about the haircut in yours? Like, does she have long hair? Because it's such a big deal in the show was her haircut.
Her 70s hair.
Does she have 70 hair?
I think she's going to have 70s hair.
One last question. Do you want to believe?
I believe. I'm superstitious. I believe in everything until, you know, proven otherwise.
Mm-hmm.
And the more great science fiction that you read by, you know, authors like Jonathan, the easier it is to believe.
I was raised by a grandmother who's kind of like an 80-year-old version of Luna Lovegood from Harry Potter. She believed in everything. So I got a bit of that. I'm open-minded to everything. I want to believe in everything. Mm-hmm. I don't believe in everything, but I want to.
Okay.
And with UFOs, I like the Drake's formula, the statistical model for the likelihood of alien life. They made a good case for the number of planets that would likely have civilizations advanced as ours. So yeah, I'm a believer. I just don't know if we've ever actually had like lunch with any of them.
Right.
But we'll see.
I believe that even if you've never watched a single episode of The X-Files, if you read these books, you will be big fans of Mulder and Scully.
You should be. It's an amazing show, and I'm so excited for my young audience to be opened up to my favorite television show.
But again, like one of the things that was really important to us is that no one has to have read, have seen a single episode of The X-Files to read the books.
Yeah.
They're thrillers, they're fun, they have romance and action. And then if you do know the X-Files, there's a lot of bonus.
They're not written as backstory, they're written as entry points.
Yes. So thank you guys for coming and for being a part of my video. And
thank
I'm so
you.
Excited. When are the books coming out, by the way?
January 3rd.
January 3rd. Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. That's so rude of me. I didn't realize you guys were there. I hope you guys enjoyed the X-Files video. I filmed it back at Comic-Con, and I'm premiering it now because Agent of Chaos and the Devil's Advocate, the X-Files origin stories, are out now on January 3rd. You don't need to watch the show to read the books. Of course, watching the show obviously enhances the reading experience, so you should watch the show. Thank you all for watching, and I hope you all believe, because I want to believe. Agent Gina Harper,